I've got beige jar, turpentine, pouring that in, talked about this, get pouring down the sink, and those other type of things. Now you just need a little bit of this. Now you want to also just be careful. I would prefer pouring it because it'll splatter. I've got this in my eyes before. This is dangerous just to pour. So this is, and it's extremely expensive. This is, you know, $30 here. So this is expensive. That's probably even too much. All right, so I've got a little too much on there right off the bat. So you can see how much is in there. That's probably a little too much. Okay, but anyway, we'll make it work. Watch out. Right there. Okay, so right-handed, I'm going to put everything on my right-hand side. This is going to be my tabouret right here. Boom. Now, you could use the tables. You could also use a chair. Okay, but you got to have something to your, if you're left-handed, left, right, you know, whatever the case may be. Okay? All right, so, okay, now, the canvases, like I said, we got a bunch of those to use. Now, I like to usually use, sometimes I'll use under the things, two or three canvases, pallets to kind of get it going. These are all the colors we're using on this, okay? And for today, I'll have these made up for you Wednesday when you come in. These will all be set, your pallets will be ready to roll. So just grab it and go, okay? So, number one, white, you're going to use a lot of white. Even if you're going to paint on your own, go to wall painting on yourself, you could get little tubes on some colors. White, you got to go bigger. Okay, this is kind of like acrylic, same idea. Needs a lot of white. Now notice this paint, in acrylic always said a little dab will do you, right? This, you can go more. A lot more paint, okay? Tons more paint. Plus it's a snow scene type painting, winter scene. Now, so you have the, you know, a lot of paint, that's, you don't throw this away. Remember that, you keep these on there. Also, don't tear off the strip. Leave it on the thing like this. You don't tear the this is like what you call wax paper, basically all it is. It's like making wax paper, that's what it is. So don't tear that off, okay? The best palettes, like I said before, are the glass palettes. Now this is a birch sienna brown. Birch sienna brown right there, okay? And the next color I'm going to go with, ultramarine blue. That was a titanium white that I used. There's also a flake white. You don't want to give that one unless you're going to take it. Force painting, I didn't want to talk about the texture. I didn't put a ultramarine. Okay. Ultramarine blue. Ultramarine blue. It's dark blue, okay? A little touch of purple in it. It's dark blue, okay? Use the blue color there. And then you got your cerulean blue. Ango loves cerulean as well, and yellow ochre and some of those colors. The ochre's in that sunflower painting over there. And then you got the cerulean blue, kind of a sky light blue color. Now normally you want to keep all the similar colors together on your palette, you know, the same area. You know, Syrah, he did this just like a color wheel, okay? But this is the paint we got to use. Turpentine's right here. And then now here we go. Now, so here's what we got. Okay, now, this is a brand new brush. This is a bristle brush. I always like to kind of run through it to make sure no hairs fall off. These aren't the most expensive. They're decent brushes, though. They're good quality. You still want to kind of make sure on the bristle brush that you get the brush hairs off of there. Carefully just doing this, you kind of get splinters with this too sometimes. So you got these here going, and then you're ready to go. Now this was one a photo that I took in a mission over in New Mexico a couple years ago in a snowstorm that I wouldn't want to go through again, but I'll definitely probably try it again maybe here in a couple weeks. But this is kind of what we're going to go with. Now normally I'll hit like just some trees and some stuff and let's see what I got. We'll try this out. Here's what you want to do, okay? Well, this is going to be a little different than kind of what I've normally done, but I'm going to try to make the paintings painting and see if I'll finish one. Sometimes I don't have to finish it. Now, so here's the first step. Now, let's say if you're doing a portrait background. Portrait, you go to background, do it. Still life, background, just use the same way. Skies, this is how you do it, okay? So you take your, we're going to go with our ultramarine blue. Now, my sky is pretty much here. This is all mountains and trees right here. So I'm going to have a smaller area of sky here. Now, this is going to be a pretty light sky, so there's not going to be much in this thing. One thing I forgot, too, is a lot of times I'll put a little bit of turps on here, turpentine. Well, sorry, I hope you have to do that. But put a little bit of turpentine on there. Just let it flow and go a little better, okay? and it just kind of blends a little with it, you know, a little bit. But so anyway, that you might want to do before you start. But when you do that, remember, if you don't want anything here, it's going to splatter out, just spray out on it. So make sure your area is safe to where you're at. There's nobody set up right next to you or someone's artwork. Okay, because it will ruin that. Now, all right, so we got a little blue on there. Now, I'm not going to clean the brush. I'm going to go to the cerulean. One of the cerulean blue. Now, again, this is a small area of sky that I normally do here. So hopefully it's going to be there your technique. Again, I just sketched out in the pencil. Then normally I don't even sketch anything out. I'm just going to do it. But now I'm going to hit a little speck of the burnt sienna brown. Now, it's how warm you want this picture, put more brown if you want it warmer. If you want it, or the tint of color you want, maybe brownish look to it more. But the burnt sienna is brown, it's kind of the orange family, so it's a little more of a warm color than a cool color. Of course, the blue is obviously the cool color. So, and also you can get more of a stormy sky look if you do add more brown. But this is just a touch of brown in there, not a whole lot of that, just a little bit in there. Now we're ready for the next step. Okay, now it's when I'm going to clean my brush for the first time. If you got a brand new brush, it's going to stay blue like this forever. You're never going to get this out. You get it on your hands today, the paint, you got to wash your hands. You eat the old paint, drink turpentine, you'll be dead before you get out the door there. Okay, very deadly. So wash your hands. Now your hands are going to be blue if you get blue paint on it, but at least use a washer. Okay, it'll be blue for 3 days. Okay, no, just that's just the way it is. Okay, so get some paint, got playing on you. Get some stuff. You got to look like an artist. You got to live it. If you got to want it and have a passion for it. That's all it's about, guys. Repetition and practice over and over. Okay? It's a great quote. Yeah. That's a great quote. There's so many out there. Now, all right, so now we dry it on. Now I like to hold the paint, the thing in my hand. I like to hold it in my hand. Some people hold a palette, you know. But I don't know that a really artist really holds a palette in their hand necessarily, but a few liters on the side there. Now, so the next step, we're going to bring it into the white, right? All right, so we clean the brush out. Now we're blending it out. Now I may knock this out in 30 seconds, 2 minutes. It may take me 30 minutes to get this to how I want. Okay, you just never know. Now, so we're painting the sky, and I want this to be a pretty light sky. This is going to be darker probably than my picture is, but the snow, if you think of a snow scene type sky, the skies are real gray and just nearly white. They're not as blue or, you know, dark as you would normally think. So now you want to watch the snowy effect. Watch the snowy effect, okay? That's the white canvas showing through. Make sure you're painting thick enough. You just did some acrylic, so a little bit back into the acrylics. You wouldn't want to go watercolor oil just like that. You want to kind of, you got to kind of take a little time to get that consistency of that paint in there that you're looking for. So different. Yeah. And if you couldn't do this all day long, you'd definitely be in the wrong place. Nothing much better. Okay, now again, here's the reason, big reason for the easel. You can step back, see what you have, okay? I can't tell what I've got up this close, okay? So, remember, the turpentine acts as your brush cleaner and your thinner. It's just like the water and, you know, for watercolor or acrylics. Okay, now, so I have a little sky there. Now, I'm going to show you how to do it like a cloud in the sky. Just in case your sky, you may have a bigger sky. Okay, like I said, if you've got some pictures of snow scenes on your phone, maybe you went Flagstaff, you took some pictures somewhere, I don't know, wherever you went to take some pictures, or you've got some pictures, maybe you found a picture online, you like the trees, you know, as long as you don't copy it exactly, maybe the trees, maybe you like the, a mountain in it or something like that. This you can kind of fix and match it, but or you just make it up. Like I said, normally on this, I just kind of, make it up. If you got an idea, it might help. But and if you want help, as we get these helping, I mean, I love helping you with this painting probably more than any that we do. And I'll make these look good for you. And this will definitely be one of the gifts that keeps on giving. So we can keep it going. So now we're adding a little bit of white, a little bit of maybe a cloud in here. Okay. So just, and of course this is wet paint. This is gonna be wet for 2 or 3 days. Okay. So we're gonna add a little bit of some pure white in here. Now we're gonna put a little
shadow, maybe a little bit of the brown, a little dark blue and brown.
A little bit of a shadow under there. Like a little on there. A little shadow underneath here.
Okay.
And then now the next step we'll do is kind of soften that up a little bit. Just lightly up the feather over the paint. Very lightly here. Kind of soften that in. Okay. And then kind of go back and you gotta stand back. You can't see what you're doing up close. You gotta stand back and see.
Yep.
See what it is you're working with here. A little more white right in here. Like I said, the sky is not much. It's not the main focus on this particular painting. This one here, I'm doing. Okay, so I have a lot of sky in this. Now, the next part we got going here. Taking a little longer on the sky than I wanted to, but all right, here we go. All right, so the next part. Now, again, yours, I would probably stay away from buildings and things like that, if there's something really small. Stay away from animals on this particular painting. You can do those next semester. You don't got time to do animals or people on this, okay? You don't have time for it, okay? So you just want to keep it landscape, trees, mountains, pathway, roadway, that kind of thing. Stream, something like that, okay? And sorry, normally that's what I do. I'm just going to try to get this other picture. Now, all right, so let's see what we got. Okay, so now we're right here. With some we'll call our sky. You can go back and fix it. Maybe you don't like what you got so far. Take your paint rag, wipe through the whole thing, and just start again, okay? You can do that. You can fix any mistake on this paint. Watercolor, stuff like that, it's not easy. Just any mistake you made, you can totally fix it, okay? All right, so now the next step here, you've got to clean up the brush a little bit. Normally when you clean up the brush, you want to hold the jar in one hand, okay? Don't just put the brush, hold it with your opposite hand, grip it pretty tight, really tight, actually. And then you want to, these brushes are sturdy, really vigorously, you know, hear them hit the side. But you want to hold that brush and thing. So the next step, we'll hit the mountains, okay? I'm going to go with the mountain background. We'll come in the house a little bit later on, and we'll get to that today. Now, the house part, we'll hit the mountains next. So, notice I've still got the big brush. Still going big brush, okay? So, and you should have one similar to this. I thought we had some very brownies. Now, more a little bit of blue. Actually, all three colors. All three of the blues. All three of the blues. And we're just going to put our mountains. I'm going to put a little one on here. And at the top, where we left off here, we're going to go right off this edge here. So I'm getting a line there at the top. And one other thing I've done, and I'm not sure what the heck I'm doing, but normally do this. It's not wrong way necessarily. It's not really the normal way I do it. Now, normally I would have colored this whole background. But anyway, that's all right. Because it's not a sky. That's what it is. Now, all right, so here's what we got. Here. Now, here's what we got. Okay. Who would have thought you could get these kind of colors with just two blues and a brown and a white?
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna blend this down a little bit. This is kind of where I'll go back to the step. So we need to get a little bit of color on here. So I'm gonna dab a little of these, just kind of all through my brush. Just dab a few of these in here. garden area here of this here. So we're gonna dab this in. And basically, you're just gonna blend this stuff out. The cool thing about this color, now if this was watercolor, I mean, you already had problems of, you know, using hard edge line. Well, the problem with this will be wet still tomorrow. Okay. So more of a creamy texture to it. That texture is the easy acrylics. So much real the difference is I think the two. Acrylics fade, gold's real. I mean that's what I can describe it. Alright, so let's say here what we got here. We're gonna take the white, just gonna blend this out. I like to get a base color kind of. That way I don't have to worry about snowy effect and stuff like that in there. So I kind of like to get a base, just kind of build up a little texture, a little paint in there. I like to get a base on it before I kind of get this going. This is a large mountain range here. In Mayo, New Mexico, you go up to Santa Fe, like I said, you'll take that drive up to go up to Taos, go up to opposite direction, going up to George O'Keefe's house. Got some time, go through it, feel the country up there. Now, see what you got. But you gotta be careful sometimes these type of years for snow. The roads, they close down and they're dangerous if you get traffic. Which I've been interested in those areas, but so if you want to get up there and enjoy the outdoors and the beauty of nature, and this is where it's a major artist lives. All right, so we're just getting a base on here, getting a base on this thing here. Getting a base color. It sounds like a drum and a beautiful sound. That's good. What you want.
It pokes a hole.
All right, so we're getting a base here, and I'll come back and first detail. This is going to take me longer than normal picture. So let's take it here. But all right. Let's look through here the full year when we have have it on video when we do another demo again. We'll do another one. Let's get that way. Okay, all right. So now we don't have to worry about streaks in there and stuff like that, or a snowy effect. That covered up, and then we can put our trees and mountains on the side of this thing here. So again, I mean, for any kind of landscapes, you can do it quickly. This one doesn't have animals or people, which will definitely take longer. You can do it still pretty quickly. I kept working, I'm going to say this by the end of the day, but what's going on. But anyway, all right, so we've got the base in there. All right, so here we are. Now we'll go back and put that duplicate stuff. So look at this, I'm still with the big brush though. After all that, still with the big brush. In this particular picture, with the lighting, there's New Mexico, it's a little tricky on this one to see where my light and shadow is here.
Move.
Okay, any questions so far on the... You okay?
No.
Okay.
No questions.
Okay, all right. So I can come around and help you out and make sure everyone has a good picture to look over. If you are going to Walmart or Target tonight or something, help out with that, help the family, just, yeah, to kind of get us out here with all the cards. That's okay. Now, sorry, any questions here going into this? All right, so here we go. We're kind of rolling with it here now. Now, the next step that we've got in here, did a little bit of tree stuff and just various kind of things in this thing here. There we go. Now, all right, so all right, so let's see kind of what we got here with this other bottom part. But basically, you put some dappa color on there. You're going to go with the paint. And we're going to put a little few dabs down here. Some foreground area here. And to make this brown just darker, just add a darker blue with it. Okay. All do just the basic what I normally do, and I thought of this so that's nice. I'm gonna do a couple weeks here going back. I'm gonna do a picture of a couple of those other ones, those additions, I'll show you a few of those that we have. Now, yeah, you want to have the same colors throughout the picture. Any kind of landscape, it could be one, you know, like this one over here. You've got these same kind of pictures, or same kind of colors down at the bottom, too. Okay, you don't want to have this two separate pictures there, two separate paintings. You want to have the same kind of paintings throughout. All right, so now we're getting into the, let me throw in a couple of trees here. Throw in a couple of trees, show you what that looks like. Okay.
Mr. Gerson, can I interrupt just
for a second? Yes.
Have you gotten any donations for Adopt a Family?
Not at all.
Stuff?
No. Uh-oh. No, I got
$5. Okay. Well, just for what's on the list?
No, nothing on the list.
Have you gotten anything
for Adopt a Family? Yeah, they're trying to help us out. So. Okay. All right.
Okay, someone here we go. Screen for helping me.
Today. No, the last day is the 14th. What's today? The 12th, so that'd be Wednesday. Wednesday's the last day. Wednesday's the last day. Okay, now, your thin brush, you have your round thin brush, and I got a little small flat brush here, I'll grab a thin brush too in a minute. To do some tree, I'm going to bring some tree up kind of right around this edge here. But basically, the trees, you do just like we did with watercolor. Thinning it down. Now I've got it painted a lot thinner. Come up closer, can you even see better? And we're just going to put a bunch of trees right up in here. But notice that this is still wet paint. These trees just paint right up on it. See? You're painting it. You're painting right in there. Plus, I don't want them too dark anyway because it's a snow scene. And it's barely holding. Look, I'm holding it with two fingers, just like using the edge of the flat brush, kind of like a chopstick. Okay. It's very thin, okay, and you're getting, some trees right there, right? What color are the trees? Hey, blue, a little brown, a little blue. I don't want them just straight brown. You know, you should have picked up that much right now to know, trees, not just green. Now, if you do want green trees on this, like pine trees, mix the cerulean blue, that's the light blue, with the burnt sienna, boom, you get pine tree green. Pine tree green, okay? You would have thought you'd get that, those colors. So you can get a green out of this too, if that's what you want. You don't have to put leaves on the end of trees. All right, so we're just getting, again, trees, have lots of branches on them. All right, so there's gonna be trees up in here too. A few other trees and things like that. So here we go, we're rolling. No. Now most of my mission paintings have not been, this is the only snow scene that I've attempted so far, so I'm going to throw this one in the little series of those that I have. And that's it.
Hey, Texas Tech University, that's a good school.
Oh, Texas, yeah, not bad.
That's some really cool people who went there.
Yeah, how's it going?
My wife. What's up, Pat? I have a question.
Oh, okay, what's that?
A little bird told me that you might have a slide projector.
Oh, yeah. Oh, right.
Can I borrow it?
Yeah, yeah.
It's because right. I have some really old people that came to my house and they brought a slide. And I'm like,
that's awesome.
Old people.
You had a tray in
there. No, I don't have a tray. All I have is a slide in there.
Okay. Yeah, I just need that. And it's somewhere that's in the tray. I'll get you a tray, though.
Okay.
It's in the
No, I can. You can go ahead and finish your art. I'll come back with lunch. How's that?
Okay, yeah, yeah. Okay, I'll bring it. Yeah.
Yeah, you guys didn't know what this was, did you?
I showed them earlier. We looked at the beginning of the year or something.
Yeah, my wife's pants showed up with pictures of my wife when she was like 4 or 5, so I can sit around and laugh.
Okay.
Her haircuts from 1977.
That's cool. That's perfect.
All right.
Awesome.
Go back to beginning drawing. Is that a landscape from, say,
this is in New Mexico.
Scotland? Oh,
New Mexico.
I was only off 7,000 miles, so it's close.
Yeah, it's in New Mexico.
At least I knew that was a hill.
Yeah, it just started. This is a mission.
Cool.
Trees and,
nice.
So now we're doing it.
Nice. You remind me of that. What was the guy from PBS that used to drink?
Oh, right there, Bob Ross.
Yeah, that's what I felt like when I was getting here.
I believe.
You'd be like, in here, let's put a few little trees over here. You guys are more watching. You always put trees everywhere. Put a little tree over here. Put a baby tree over here. And then I would try it and I could draw some lots. By the way, I would have had straight A's in the ninth grade, except for my beginning drum teacher gave me a B.
Really?
Yeah. I drew a duck and I thought it was fantastic and he said no.
So. That's a goose.
Is, but the teacher destroyed my career. I would have been something if it weren't for him. So, all right.
Alright, yeah, we'll get to
I'll
that
come
tray.
Back at lunch.
Alright, yeah, we'll get to that tray.
I appreciate it.
Yeah.
You know, these things still existed.
So how'd it go at the band party the other night?
It was good.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
Is he playing any old Uncle Nasty songs? Or?
No.
Oh, no.
No,
okay.
No, we didn't bring any of that.
Okay.
Maybe next time. All right. Later, Hodges.
Well, that's part of this. Okay.
Okay, did you pause the video?
No.
Well, let's see here. Here's the angle. This is what I normally do on the journey.
This is normally one that we would do.
That one for damage speed. So that's normally one there. That we would do. Here's another one. One like that. Okay. So these are some other ones that have gone a little more around the skin. So these are some that's got a few of the green trees on there. So that's another way you can do it. Okay? As you get these things going. So these are some other ways. There's some other ones there to take a look at also, okay? All right, as we get, but you can see it's the same colors, and going now. So we got a lot of these little trees, a lot of snow we're gonna put on there. This is gonna be some pure white. But I need to grab another brush here and look at the, thing here. Alright, so let's try this out. Okay, so we're gonna start painting in the house. A little adobe. Mission. Anyone been to this place?
No.
Anyone been to New Mexico before?
Yes.
What part did you go?
Albuquerque.
Albuquerque?
Not too far away. Do you live there?
I used to.
Oh, really? Did you go up to this place?
No.
Why not?
Because I was 3.
Oh, okay. So Albuquerque,
you should be Taylor in their little baby.
That's where they film a lot of movies. So now
this can finally be there.
A lot of movies, I think. That's hilarious.
Just paint a baby in the window so it's really...
Breaking Bad, they film that up there.
I was only in Albuquerque for like an hour because our plane was delayed and I had to go up or something. And so,
oh. Yeah. Yeah. One of my favorite places.
Did you just live there?
No, I'm sorry. There's a lot of art here. This place is about an hour and a half away from there.
What's the capital of New Mexico?
Santa Fe. New Mexico?
Santa Fe.
He goes back to the glasses. Can you see what the trick is?
Hmm?
You can't see the chocolate.
What the?
I don't want to stand up.
Gotta get up in the end.
By Wednesday.
Wednesday?
Wednesday. Wednesday the 14th before they gotta have it on.
So just do what you can do. Please help. Help out. Need a little bit.
We'll help.
Okay?
Yeah, get a little closer up on there. Yeah. The video.
Don't drop it.
This is not just straight brown, not straight blue, some mix. Trying to get this textured look and make that shadowed area now. These are kind of place that's Shemayo. Slightly here a little bit of paint it, but and I see kind of what we got going here. Happy so far. Yeah. Snowy effect's big, you don't want to have that. Make sure you get the snowy effect out of things. Some little white canvas specks in there. Question so far. Which time we doing here? These are good brushes here. These brushes you got are good. These are very good brushes. Quality paint too. Yeah. Paint with brushes. I don't know what was good last year. Good. I'll get you some good pictures here going. Good stuff, guys. How are we doing over there?
Good.
Come up close. Look at her. Look at it closer. Let's see. Things look different up close. Look at her back sometimes. Once you start this stuff, you will not want to leave. Just want to keep it going.
Keep it going.
How much time we got left, guys? How much time we got? How much time we got left here? What are we thinking here? What do we got time-wise?
I don't know.
Consistency of this paint here. Questions so far, guys? Any questions on anything with the old paint? Remember where to put the paints at the end? How much time we got? Okay, let's kind of go over. I said I'm not going to be able to the thinnest here. So trees, thin it down. You know how to do the trees, right? Thicker trunks. If you got a big tree coming somewhere, stuff like that. Like I said, over here, the one over here, big tree, scan over here and get this one here a little bit. Let's get this thing in here. Right here. Pathways, thicker at the bottom. Pathways a little thicker at the bottom. Like I said, this one here is not done. You could put more trees here. Thicker trunks, thinner, the branches, same way we did here. Light side, dark side on the mountains, okay? Don't just start straight brown. Okay, you want to go a little blue in there too. If you want a warmer kind of total look, you can go a little more of the brown. So still don't forget that blue. But texture down here at the bottom, you can see thicker paint, even palette knife type paint possibly you could use there too. But thicker texture. You can feel a little roughness there. See, it's thicker, thins out as it goes back. Lighter, the pathway goes up. And then this one here, of course, you have to put more snow in, put more of the trees, you know, things like that. So two totally different looks there, but the same colors, okay? The same color. So now, what you want to do at the end, clean your brush out very well. Different than the other paint. It actually cleans easier than an acrylic brush. Clean them out. Put the lid on your turpentine. If we leave the lids off, now it's not going to affect you, but I mean, I'm going to be floating out here at 3 o'clock, okay? Because I mean, the fumes are going to get really bad. I mean, I'll be just like bouncing off the walls, rolling out the door. So this stuff is bad. I mean, I've already gotten a lot of the brain cells over the years. Put the lid on. It's still going to be bad enough. I mean, it's still going to be bad enough just with the stuff in here. The smell is phenomenal, but you'll, I mean, tomorrow when you walk in, next few days, the more much all of you start painting, I mean, it's going to have a strong smell here, you know, okay? So, now, what do you do with that? You got to throw it away? No, I can use that tomorrow. Okay, so now, okay, so Chris, open up one of those deals right there. Open up a deal, okay? And then what you'll do with yours, I'm going to use this maybe later, you're just going to set it right in there. Don't stack them. There's two different areas. Just stack it. Just put it right in there. Should be enough for everybody. The jars, two places to put the jars. Either right there or on the yellow cabinet. One of the two spots, jars and racks. Okay, so you got to put your jar somewhere. Don't leave them up around the sink and your paint rag somewhere. Now, take your paint. Now, if I got paint right here, maybe you don't, if there's already stuff on here, you can't tell. Just wipe it down anyway to make sure that doesn't ruin that next person's clothes or drawing or something. Okay, so just wipe it off, and then you just put your stuff over that counter, and that's it. Okay, so that's how you clean it. Put your brushes where you normally do, in your locker, wherever you put those. And then wash your hands. The last thing you do, wash your hands. Now, I would leave your paintings on the easels. No one else is using them. Just leave them on there. If you want to take them off, I mean, you can, but I would put them in the drying rack, but I would just leave them on there. Because if you grab this thing now on the edges, it's going to be wet paint. So then you're going to have to, again, wash your hands. So, because the last thing you want to do, you got to use the soap and wash your hands, okay? Wash your hands, and then if you have a stretch canvas like that, because you paint the edges and so on, we talked about that, you can paint the edges on the stretch canvases. Just, you know, that way, you know, if you don't have to frame them, just hang them on a wall like that. But you can frame them as well. It's cheaper to frame these kind of pictures than it is the watercolor. And yeah, because the watercolor's got to put the glass on, plus the mat. Acrylics and oils are cheaper to frame. So that's one of the things to keep in mind. But there's just different, you know, costs and all the things like that. But that's kind of the oil painting demo. Any other questions? Sometimes I'll put like a old shirt on or cloth or something. If you want that, just to keep the paint off, you know. But if you were to get paint on you, you know.
Like an apron?
You know, right there, that little paint on me right there. It'll come off, you know. So it'll come right off. Turpentine will also take it out. Turpentine will burn your skin, dry your skin out, so you don't get that. But anyway, what was your question?
Nothing.
Okay. Anybody got any questions at all on the oil paint? And you can see the clouds on this one again too. Put the blues in, same way I did there. Dab the white, pure white on. Clean the brush out. Dab pure white on. A little shadow underneath. A little darker colors. Soften it up to how much you want. And you may want the sky to smooth. You know, in my picture here, the sky's really more smooth. Right? Just to get a little more exercise for a few minutes. So that's it. And I still can't see, you know, from far away. So I want to get further back and just see really what I have there. If you want to stand back, it's like Leonardo da Vinci on The Last Supper. I mean, no one ever saw him paint that, you know?
No one ever saw him put one mark on. Every time someone would walk in the cafeteria where it was at, he would just be standing back 20 feet away staring at it. And he spent more time looking at it than he did actually working. So that's that's how you have to do. You got to be on an easel. And it's hard for me to stand up nowadays, but again, the worst thing you can do in here, the worst thing in this room, you know what the worst thing in the room is? The chair. Those are the worst things in this classroom. The chair. Okay.